Hello students, welcome to my next online class. So here I am with a new chapter, that is AC circuit or alternating current circuit. So in this video we will see that what are the different AC circuits, what are the opposition faced by an inductor, what is in opposition faced by a capacitor as well as resistor, right? So watch the video till the end and write the notes in your exercise book. Okay, so I will be giving the PDF file also, so that also you can write in your exercise book, or if you have already written from any other book, then just you have to go through the topics. Okay, so let's start our class today. So what is alternating current? So alternating current is that current which changes its magnitude and direction periodically. You see, I have drawn here an alternating current which is varying with respect to time. So alternating current is a function of time, whereas direct current is independent of time. So the magnitude of direct current, when I draw, that means it is a straight line here. So on the passage of time, the magnitude remains same, but whereas this alternating current, it changes its direction and magnitude periodically. Okay, so it has a positive half cycle as well as it has a negative half cycle. And you see, this is the peak value of alternating current. Okay, so I0 or I0 we say it as, this is the maximum magnitude of alternating current in the positive direction, and similarly here it is minus I0, that means the negative maximum of alternating current. Now when I need to write the instantaneous value of this alternating current, so instantaneous alternating current is denoted by I equals to I naught sine omega t. Okay, so this is the formula you have to remember. So why, what is I0 here? It is the peak value of alternating current. Sin omega t, because you see the current is moving in terms of sinusoidal wave. So as it is moving on sinusoidal wave, so it is denoted in terms of sine. So it can be denoted in terms of cos also if it is following a cosine wave, right? So what is omega here? Omega is here the angular frequency or the angular velocity. You see, when I say omega, omega equals to 2 pi by t. Like, if I consider here, a particle is here, the position of a particle is at point A. After some time, the particle will change its position at point B. Right? So similarly, there will be a change in particle, and if the particle comes back to A, so what is the angular displacement here? So total angular displacement is 360 degree, so this 360 is written as 2 pi, right? And total time taken is here t, so that means displacement by time is velocity. So what type of velocity? Angular velocity. Okay, so that is given by omega. Now when this time period, when it is 1 by t, we know it is as frequency. So 1 by t can be written as f, so it will become 2 pi f. So omega, that time this becomes angular frequency. Okay, so here omega equals to angular frequency here. Okay, so I naught sine omega t. Similarly for alternating voltage, so what we will get here? Similarly for alternating voltage, we will be getting V equals to V0 sine omega t. Okay, so if the voltage is varying now, then the peak value of that voltage will be V0 and sine omega t. Okay, in some book we see that it is given by E equals to E0 sine omega t or V equals to V0 sine omega t, means the same. Now what is the mean or average square value of AC? Mean or average value, the meaning is same. So what is the average value of alternating current for the first half cycle, that means for positive half cycle? So you see, there are positive half cycle as well as negative half cycle. So what is the average value of AC for first half cycle? That is given by 2I0 by pi. So this is the formula. Okay, so it has a derivation also, so for the derivation part we are not going here because it comes very less and it generally is for the CBSE or NCERT. Okay, as we are following here the ISC board here. So it is given by 2I0 by pi, where I0 is the peak value of current. Now 2i 0 pi, that is 2 by pi, if you divide you will be getting 0.637, that is 0.637 i naught. And what is the average value of alternating current for the negative half cycle? That is given by minus 2i 0 pi, that means minus 0.637 i 0. okay, so for positive half cycle the average value of AC current is 0.637 i 0, and the value of average current for the next half cycle, that is for the negative half cycle, that is minus 0.637 i 0. and then what will be the complete cycle average value of alternating current for the complete cycle? Then if you add for positive value and negative value, if you add the total values here, then we will be getting here 0, right? So the next term, next symbol, you will be seeing again and again in this chapter, that is IRMS and VRMS. So what is this IRMS and VRMS? RMS stands for root mean square. Okay, so IRMS equals to I naught by root 2, that is 0.707 I naught, and VRMS is V naught by root 2, that is 0.707 V naught. Okay, so what is IRMS and VRMS? The square root of mean square value of alternating current. That means we have seen the value of, or the average value of AC current or the alternating current is 0.637 I naught for the positive half, and for the negative half we have seen that is minus 0.637 I naught, right? And for the complete cycle the value of alternating current, the mean value of alternating current is 0. Now when we find the square root of the average value over a complete cycle, then we will get this value, that is I naught by root 2. So let's see, we know I equals to I naught sine omega t, right? So I equals to I naught sine omega 2, this is the instantaneous value of alternating current. Now when we square both sides, so when you will square both side, we will be getting this one, or this can be written as I0 square sin square omega t or I square, right? So here you see, for the complete half cycle, for the complete cycle, the average value for sin square omega t is half. It has been seen experimentally that for the complete half cycle the average value of AC current or the alternating current is half here. Now if I substitute here half, that means we are finding the mean I0 into half, so in place of sine square to half, so I mean here root under I0 square by 2, or this can be written as I0 by root 2. So what is this mean? This is the RMS value. Right? So this is the RMS value, that is root mean square value of peak current. Note that RMS stands for root mean square value of current. Okay, so RMS, root mean square value of current, which is equals to I naught by root 2. Generally it has been seen that when a circuit is connected to an applied voltage, on increasing the voltage, the current does not increase simultaneously. Why it is so? Because there is some phase difference between current and voltage. So that phase difference is denoted by phi. So let us consider a circuit has been connected to an applied voltage, and that voltage is given by V equals to V naught sine omega t. And as there is a phase difference between current and voltage, so when a circuit is connected to an applied voltage, If increasing applied voltage increases the current, we say that both current and voltage are increasing simultaneously. So generally we say that their phase difference is zero or their point of origin is same. If I consider this is the voltage, alternating voltage, and if the alternating current is also starting from the same point, you see, same point here, and it is crossing the same point, and also it is meeting at the same point, then we say that their phase difference, they are in same phase, that is phase difference is zero. Okay, so generally or most of the time it has been seen that when you increase the voltage, the current is not increased simultaneously in other AC circuits. So for this we use the concept of phase here. Okay, and we draw a diagram that is called phasor diagram. So what is a phasor diagram? Phasor diagram is a diagram which is being plotted by the rotating vectors of voltage and current. So voltage and current we consider as a rotating vector, and we see what is the angle subtended between these rotating vectors, right? Now you see, the obstruction to the flow of current through a resistor is called resistance. Similarly, when a current will pass through an inductor, inductor means here coil, right? If I say resistor, that is resistor, you know this is the resistor here that is given by R. This is an inductor and this is a capacitor. Capacitor by two parallel plates here. So when an AC current will pass through this inductor, it will face some opposition. What is that opposition called? That is called reactance. Okay, and it is denoted by X. And the opposition to the flow of AC current in inductor, it is called XL, that means inductive reactance. What is the opposition to the flow of current through a resistor called? It is called resistance. Opposition to the flow of current through a capacitor, that is called capacitive reactance. Okay, and what is impedance then? That is the hindrance to the flow of AC current in the circuit. So impedance, so what is generally we say, what is the impedance in the resistor? That is resistance. What is the impedance in here? That is in inductor, that is called reactance, that is inductive reactance, and here it is capacitive reactance. Okay, so the resistance, the word which we use in case of resistor, we cannot use for inductor and capacitor. In that case, that opposition of flow of AC current, we have to say inductive reactance or capacitive reactance. Is it clear? So you see here, this was the impedance. Impedance is denoted by Z, whose SI unit is ohm, because it is the opposition to flow of current. Similarly, in inductive reactance, it is called omega L, or XL equals to omega L formula, and XC equals to 1 by omega C. Okay, so reactance, this is inductive reactance and this is capacitive reactance, and this one we say at resistance, or sometimes we say as impedance also. With the help of phasor diagram, we can find out whether this voltage or current, they are in same phase or not. If both voltage and current, they are in same phase, then we call it as purely resistive circuit. That means increase in voltage is equals to increase in current. So in that case, impedance becomes resistance, right? So what is the phasor diagram? So phasor diagram is drawn by two rotating vectors of voltage and current, and which indicates the phase difference between the two physical quantities. That is, between voltage and current, what is the phase difference here? That is being denoted by, or that we get from phasor diagram. So phasor diagram we will be drawing for purely resistive circuit, we will be drawing for purely capacitive and purely inductive circuit. So phasor diagram will show what is the phase difference between purely resistive circuit. As I have told, in purely resistive circuit means only resistor is present, like this in a circuit only resistor is present. So in a purely resistive circuit, the impedance becomes resistance. So what is that impedance in purely resistive? We say that is resistance. Okay, and in purely resistive circuit, it has been seen that current and voltage, that means E is here voltage, we can write here V also. So E and I both are in same phase, that means increase in voltage increases the current. Okay, so because phase difference is zero in purely resistive circuit. Okay, so therefore Z equals to R. Now we'll draw a diagram for phasor diagram for purely inductive circuit. Purely inductive circuit, when I say that the circuit is connecting or contain only coil, that is an inductor. Okay, inductor is denoted by L. So when a current passes, AC current or alternating current passes through an inductor, that is through coil, the phasor diagram is drawn, and it has been seen that current is lagging by 90 degree. And here, like in pure resistive, both are not in same direction. Here current is lagging by 90 degree, or we can say the voltage is ahead of current. Okay, so phi equals to minus pi by 2. So what is the phase difference here? 90 degree. So which one is leading here? Voltage is leading and current is lagging. So which can be written as V equals to V naught sin omega t. If this is the voltage, then current is lagging here. So current will be written as I equals to I naught sin omega t minus pi by 2. Okay, so this was purely inductive circuit. Now when you will draw for the pure capacitive circuit, when I say, so this is a capacitor. Okay, so when a current is passing through a capacitor, purely capacitive circuit, here V equals to V naught sine omega t, then I is said here I naught sine omega t plus pi by 2. So here it has been seen that phi is pi by 2, or you can say if this is the current and this is the voltage, so the angle between current and voltage is here pi by 2. So in inductive circuit it has been seen that current is lagging, but here in capacitive circuit it has been seen that here current is leading and voltage is lagging. You see, plus pi by 2 for current, that means current is ahead of voltage. So this diagram is called phasor diagram, which shows the angle subtended between voltage and current. Right, so what is the impedance obstruction to the flow of current in capacitor, capacitive circuit? That is given by XC, that is 1 by omega C. What is the reactance, that is obstruction to the flow of current in inductor, called, that is called XL, that is equals to omega L. Right, so few notes you will be writing from your book. You will write what is root mean square, what is average mean value of alternating current, what are the impedance, like what is the definition of impedance, reactance, capacitive reactance, inductive reactance. So the topics which I have taught today and I have noted down in the board, that you need to write in your exercise book. Okay, so you can add from your textbook few notes, okay, if you like. Okay, so see you then in my next video. Till then, goodbye.